Well, this show is a little different. We won't ask you to take part or to come up on stage or to do anything but watch. Tonight, everyone's job is to pay attention and to play detective, then vote at the end. I'll explain the voting process to you in more detail after the show. And now, let the show begin.
Welcome, everyone. Oh, it's so nice to see you all. I'm so glad you were able to come. This is fantastic.
Phyllis.
Good crowd.
Phyllis, come here. I want to talk to you.
Not now. Can't you see I'm busy with the guests? This is wonderful. A full house for the whole weekend.
Phyllis, you're tricking these people. They're here under false pretenses. If they find out the truth, we could be in a whole lot of trouble and we could be out of business.
I've got news for you. If we don't get a guest or two in the next week, we'll be out of business anyway. We're broke, Jim. This inn has been empty since we took it over until now. My plan is working beautifully.
But it's not right. Like I said, we could get into a whole lot of trouble.
We're already in a whole lot of trouble. Now just keep your mouth shut and don't screw up this weekend. Just do what I told you. Oh, why did I ever listen to him? Why did I let him spend my late husband's life insurance money on this white elephant? What was I thinking? I hate it here. I broke a nail this morning.
Oh, come on, Phyllis. It's beautiful here. You'll learn to like it.
It was beautiful in the Hamptons where we used to live. Oh, when poor Reggie died unexpectedly, he left me with a beautiful home and a big life insurance check. Then right after you and I got married, the Hampton house mysteriously burned down. And in my vulnerable state, I let you convince me to buy this dump. Oh, and now we're broke. I must have been crazy.
Oh, but Phyllis, my great grandfather built this inn, and you know very well that. And, hey, it's always been my hope, because they lost it during the Depression, that we could buy it back and have it run by the family again. It's what my grandfather would have wanted. Phyllis, you've just got to give it some time.
I've given it a whole month already. Isn't that enough? Oh, there isn't even a decent shopping mall here. What, is it hidden in the woods? And oh, who knew there'd be so many trees?
Trees are beautiful.
Yeah. Who are you, Al Gore? Now stop your daydreaming and get down to business. We finally got guests to stay here. And my brilliant plan will keep them coming back. Before long, we'll be raking in the dough.
Maybe, but I don't like this plan of yours.
Do you have a better one?
No.
Well, then shut up and do what you're told.
Phyllis, a fake ghost? I don't like it. It's dishonest. And where'd you get that whacked out DJ of yours? She's not working with a full deck. Either are our guests out here, as far as I can tell.
That is Janet, from another planet. She offered to do the job for free, and that's all we could afford. She recently got out of a mental hospital, and she's trying to break into the DJ business. And I think she's pretty harmless. Looks like she's having some trouble figuring out the equipment, though. How we doing over there, Janet?
Oh, when did they start making these records so little? I mean, every time I put it on here, I don't get any music. Must be a bad needle.
They're not records. They're CDs.
CDs? I'm talking music and he's talking finance and I'm the crazy one. That's okay, Mrs. Lodge. I'll make this work.
Okay.
That wilted flower child of yours and those folks out there scare me, Phyllis. And so does your plan of inventing a fake ghost. Where did they come from, anyway?
I advertised in magazines and on websites related to the paranormal. Oh, at best, I thought we'd get a couple of kooks to come and stay in ghost hunts. I never dreamed we'd get an entire paranormal organization to have its convention here. This is wonderful. And they're big drinkers, too. We'll make a killing this weekend.
Well, maybe, but have you taken a good look at them? They're a bunch of weirdos. I don't like it. I don't like anything about this whole weekend.
Oh, quit your whining. Their money is green, isn't it?
Maybe, yeah. But I still don't like your plan.
You don't have a better one, I know that. I already asked you that.
Okay, so what are we going to do about it?
Well, we can stay here. If you want to stay here, we'll stay here in the Poconos. Otherwise, where do you want to go?
I don't know.
Well, I'm not moving back to the Hamptons. I'm just not.
Okay. Well, Phyllis? I don't know what else to say to you.
Where'd you live your life?
Excuse me, Mr. Lodge. I'm Madame Zelda von Spuchem. I am the chairperson for tonight's festivities. Would you be so kind as to introduce me to the others?
Madame Fruitcake wants me to introduce her.
You'd be delighted to, won't you, Jim?
Yes.
I'd be delighted, Madame Fruitcake.
Von Spuchem.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Lodge and I are very, very happy to have you with us tonight for the Boo festivities. We hope you have a great time, and don't forget we have a bar, and get on the 50-50. You should do that. And if you have a moment, go by the lounge and see the wonderful fire we've built in the fireplace. It's nice and cozy and warm. And before we go on any longer, let me introduce to you tonight's hostess for the Boo festivities, Madame Zelda von Spuchem.
Thank you so much. Good evening, everyone. It's so wonderful to see so many of you Boo people here for this evening. I'm the national chairperson for the Boo organization, that is, the Boogeyman Outreach Organization. Yeah. Now, as you all know, our motto is, ghosts have feelings too. Now, all together, let's say our motto.
Ghosts have feelings too.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, before I go any further, I would like to introduce some special guests. First of all the way from London, England, Professor Lionel Spector. Professor Spector is an expert in paranormal activity and metaphysical matters. So let's welcome Professor Spector. Professor, won't you say a few words for our group? Professor, say a few words for our group, will you?
Oh, no, thank I couldn't you. Possibly. Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Professor Lionel Spector. Noted British paranormalist, and...
Excuse me, Professor, paranormalist?
Are you questioning my credentials?
Oh, no, I would never do that.
Please.
I'm just not familiar with that term.
Allow me to continue.
Oh, by all means, continue.
As I was saying, as a paranormalist, I've begun investigating any paranormal activity that may be paranormalizing at this suspected paranormal location. As soon as I uncover anything of a paranormal nature, I'll notify you all immediately. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor.
Yo, Professor, what's your sign, baby? Are you liberal or preservative?
Well, let's hope that the professor is successful in finding a ghost. After all, that's what we're all here for, isn't it? And now, I'd like to introduce from our Washington, D.C. headquarters,
Mr. Max Smolder and Miss Dana Scullery.
Thank you.
Oh, I think we're a bit shy. That's okay, we'll all get to know each other in no time.
Trench coats, eh? Last time I wore one of those, I almost got 3 to 5 years.
Well, now moving right along, it's clear that the lodges believe they have paranormal activity going on here. They think they have a ghost living here. It's our job to find out if this is true, and if it is, then we must make contact and help the spirit move to the other side. But before we do this, we have to ask for a blessing to protect us from geopathic stress. I mean, we wouldn't want to have any naughty paranormal activity.
Oh, be quiet, Jim. I think our opportunity is coming. Now, just move when I tell you.
Okay, now, everybody repeat after me.
Okay, Jim, go.
But I don't want to.
Go!
Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo! Yes, I'm beginning to feel some psychic vibrations. And they're coming close. They're near me. They're right. I can feel them. Are you mocking me? Has this entire haunting of yours been a hoax?
I told you it wouldn't work.
A flowered sheep, you idiot!
Well, I couldn't find the white one.
Be patient, Madam Zelda. We'll have a real ghost here in just a second. Because I'm gonna kill my stupid husband.
Wait, there is someone or something near. Did you hear that?
I didn't hear that, did you?
I don't want to hear anything.
I'm probably the only one who can hear and feel that psychic vibration. I'm going to have to do a seance. I'll need an assistant. Yes, you. Come over here. Sit down and put your hands on the table and concentrate. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Oh! Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Back there. I see something back there. I can't quite make it out. I'm going to have to come forward. Yes, it's a woman. And she's wearing a wedding gown. Oh. Oh, yes, dear. Come right up. Yes. Sit down, won't you? Oh, dear. Excuse me. What is that? Oh, you look fine, dear, all things considered. Would you mind if I took notes?
No.
Well, let's begin. What is your name? Her name is Olivia.
Olivia.
Yes. And how did you die, Olivia? She was murdered. Oh. And when was that? Yeah. October 31st, 1911. Oh. Why, that's 100 years ago tonight. Oh. Olivia, how can we help you? Are you related? Are you connected to this place in any way? Oh, you say you're related to somebody who lives here. And who is that? You're Mr. Lodge's great aunt?
Oh, no. I'm not related to any dead people. No.
Shut up and listen.
How can we help you, Olivia? Would you like us to help you move over to the other side?
Somebody was there, and I...
No, but you don't want to stay here. It's too disturbing. Where would you like to go? You want to relocate to the country villa?
No!
Yes, yes, go, go, go. I'll go get the door.
Knock it off, Jim.
Okay. Well,
did you, anybody else in on this ghost hoax of ours?
No, did you?
No.
Oh.
Are you sure? Now, okay, Olivia, you want to relocate to the country villa, and why would you want to go there? Oh, I see. Oh, where are you going? No, no, I have so much more to ask you. Don't go. Olivia, come back. Oh.
Olivia, how nice to meet you.
He's not there, Professor.
Batteries must be dead.
Phyllis, I'm scared. I'm beginning to believe this ghost stuff is for real. My father told me stories about my great aunt Olivia. There's no way Madame Fruitcake could have known anything about her.
Oh, I think this stuff is for real, too. This is wonderful.
This is terrible.
No, it's wonderful. Now I don't have to worry about you and the flowered sheet anymore. I've got the real thing.
Yeah.
You mean you want the ghost here?
Of course I do. When other wacko organizations like this one get the word, we'll be book solid every day of the year.
But are you forgetting that Madame Fruitcake has said she's going to relocate the ghost?
I know what she said, but if she tries to relocate our ghost, I'll kill her.
Phyllis.
Don't Phyllis me.
But do you...
No buts now. Go fluff a pillow or something.
Will you two stop fighting? So we grab a flower cheat. He made a mistake. Anybody could do that. Now quit. Stop fighting in front of our guests. You're embarrassing them.
Yes.
I'm going to put on some so nice, calming music. It'll make you feel friendlier. You'll see.
You make my heart sad. You make everything groovy.
Get it!
After all.
Oh, shut up.
Scullery, have you been noticing this? They have a real ghost here. This could be our big break.
Down, boy. Don't go up on some wild ghost chase. We're just here to watch the professor over there.
Really?
Yeah.
This is going to be our opportunity to get the Bureau to open up the hedge files again. We were so close to proving the truth is out there, then they shut us down. But if we bring back a real ghost...
Smulder, get a grip. You're already the laughingstock of the whole Bureau. What with all your aliens and your ghost chases and your vampire nonsense. Granted, the Bureau did start the Hex Files division in order to check out the truth of all this paranormal business. But you got obsessed. You got out of control. It was all I could do to keep them from firing his butt. You know? So don't blow this assignment, because this time I won't be able to protect you. Remember, hey, focus.
Scullery, we were so close to proving the truth is out there, and here it is, right under our noses.
Oh, Smulder, you mean that silly flowery ghost they had? That was just a cheap parlor trick by them, by the lodges and Madame Zelda.
I know to focus. But I believe that it's true. I really believe that it's true.
Do you think the professor is really the professor? Do you know, I think he is. I think he's about to, you know, like, I think we have that chat with him, and I think he's about to come here now. There he is.
Are you coming here now?
Yeah.
He's here.
Hello, Professor. Excuse me. What are you looking for?
Ghost droppings.
Oh, ghost droppings, right.
That's logical to me.
It would. I'm curious, Professor. Where was it that you attended school?
I beg your pardon?
I mean, where did you get your paranormalcy degree?
I attended the England University of Paranormalcy, making me a doctor of paranormalcy and related paranormal matters. Or simply put, a paranormalologist.
I see!
You would. And just how did you get involved with the Boo organization?
Well, when I was going through my desk, I came across a letter from Madame Zelda to him, me, inviting me to the inn. The letter described ghostly activities, and Madame Zelda invited me here to see if I could be of assistance.
And no other reason?
What other reason could there be? Now, if you'll excuse me.
Wait, Professor! Do you really believe that there are ghosts here?
Smulder, knock it off.
It's an innocent question. That's an innocent question.
But I promised the director I would keep your mind off all this paranormal nonsense.
One question, Professor. Do you believe that there are really ghosts here?
How the hell should I know? I mean, I don't have enough evidence to make any assumptions. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm very busy.
You know, I'm really suspicious of him now. Let's follow him. Come on.
All right, you go first. I'm right behind
you. Okay.
Oh, great Caesar's ghost! Do you know how dangerous it is to interrupt a trance? Do you want the sky to fall in on us? Why, anything could happen!
That's what I was hoping for!
What do you mean?
Do you really believe that there is a ghost here of some woman named Olivia?
Of course she's here. I know what I saw with my own eyes and what I heard with my own ears. She is here, somewhere. I'm the only one who has her psychic vibrations. That's why I'm the only one who can see her. Although I don't know why the professor can't see her.
Is there any way we can capture her? I understand that there are ways to.
No, of course not. No, you can't do that. You can't capture her, though. She wants us to relocate her, and that's what we're going to do.
Okay, well then let's relocate her to Washington, D.C. She can haunt the White House. Luckily, Bush isn't there anymore, but some say Lincoln still is. They will get along great.
No, no, not Washington. I've heard that they have a special section of the FBI called the Hex Files. And they might find a way to capture Olivia and take her to the Hexagon building. And who knows what they'd do to her there.
Madam Zelda.
No, we're going to help her relocate down to the country villa.
Madam Zelda.
I don't know why she'd want to go there. The food is lousy.
Madam Zelda, I suggest you reconsider.
Excuse me, Mr. Smulder. Do you have your your membership card for the Boo organization? I didn't think you were really a member.
Madam Zelda, I strongly suggest you reconsider. What? What? Scullery, I'm busy, what? No, no, can't you watch him yourself? All right, I'll be right there. We'll talk later, Madam Zelda.
Olivia, it's so good to see you. You came back. Come, sit down, dear.
Ah, Madam Zelda. Taking a rest from all this ghost hunting I see. It can be tiring, yes. Perhaps I'll take a load off my feet, too.
No, Professor, don't!
Well, hello, dear!
Olivia!
It's me!
Uh-oh.
You have no idea how nice it is just to breathe again. Although I must say, these male bodies aren't all they're cracked up to be. I feel like a tripod.
How long can you stay in the professor's body, dear?
Not long, sweetie. So you better tell me quick what's on your mind.
Well, just how did you die?
It was exactly 100 years ago, today. My boyfriend Rocco and I were married. He never really wanted to get married. So I guess I should have been suspicious when he suddenly popped the question. Especially when he suggested honeymooning here in the Poconos at my uncle's inn. Back then, it was all just dirt roads with nothing around for miles. But if that's what it took to get him to marry me, I was willing to make the sacrifice.
And
Egyptian artifacts. The morning of our wedding, I read that someone had broken into the Museum of Ancient Things and had stolen the gold artifacts from the tomb of the Egyptian pharaoh, King Rutten.
And it was Rocco?
Yeah, who knew? I thought he was a window washer.
And then what happened?
Well, we had this huge argument, and I guess he never, the only reason he really came out was to, he married me, was to have a place to hide till the heat died down. He never really loved me. I felt so used.
Oh, you poor thing.
Yes, that's not the worst of it. We had this huge argument. I told him that I was going to turn him in as I refused to be an accessory to a crime.
Of course.
He told me he was going to go up to the room and take a nap, and then after that, we'd go for a walk and talk some more. But instead of going to our room, he went out into the woods and took the trunk with him. I know this. I followed him. I saw him bury the treasure in the woods. Terrified that he'd see me, I ran back to our room. Later that night, when he returned, we finally went for that walk and talked some more.
Something tells me that was the last walk you took together.
I'm afraid so. I told him that he had to turn himself into the police and return the treasure of King Rutten. That I couldn't go along with this. But instead, he grabbed my legs, flipped me up into the air, and sent me flying down the well.
Oh, my!
Yes, what a trip that was.
Why have you stayed here all these years?
Some sort of Egyptian curse. My soul is bound to this property until the treasure of King Rutten is found and returned.
You mean the treasure is still out there in the woods somewhere?
Yes.
And if we find the treasure, you will be free to leave.
Yes.
Oh, let me see if I have this straight now.
Wait, but back to my story.
Oh.
That night, when I returned to the room, I made a map of where he hid the treasure. But it's been 100 years. I don't know what's become of that. If you find that map, you'll find the treasure. And my soul will be free from the curse.
So if we find the map, you'll be free to leave this place.
Yes.
Oh, let me see if I have it straight now. 100 years ago, your husband Rocco brought you here for your honeymoon.
Yes.
And then you found out that he had stolen the treasure from the Museum of Ancient Things, the exhibit King Rutten.
Yes.
But when you wouldn't go along with it, he killed you by throwing you down the well.
Yes, yes.
But not before you made a map showing where everything is buried.
Yes, yes.
Oh, my goodness. And if we find that map, you'll be free to leave this place.
Yes, yeah. Oh, yes.
Ooh, I'm good for the night.
Was that good for you?
I'm good for the night.
Well, why did Rocco leave the treasure here? Why didn't he take it with him?
He never got the chance. A few days after my disappearance, he mysteriously tripped and fell all the way from the top of the stairs down to the bottom and broke his neck. Oh. I wonder how that happened. Yeah.
What happened?
You don't know?
No, the last thing I remember was sitting in that chair, and then it was getting slapped. What happened?
Well, when you sat in that chair, you sat on Olivia's lap. And then Olivia's spirit possessed you.
I don't know why. I must have a cold. That's why I didn't
recognize
her.
That's why you didn't see her, yes.
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 And Olivia saw what?
Her spirit possessed you.
Oh, my God!
And she told us everything that had happened 100 years ago. You came here on your honeymoon, and you found out that Rocco had stolen the treasure from King Rutten from the Museum of Ancient Things, and that they buried the treasure out there in the woods, and then Rocco died and disappeared mysteriously.
So it's pretty much lost forever.
Well, no. There's a map.
What map?
Olivia made a map just before she was killed, showing where the treasure is buried.
A map?
And if we find that treasure, she'll be free to leave this place.
A map? We must find that. I want that map.
Relax, Professor. We'll find the map. Why don't we ask the Boo people to help us look for it? Look under your chairs, under your table, see anything that you have that looks like a map, and bring it up here.
And if you find that map, give it to me.
I found it! Oh, no, give it to me!
Not at all. You're in charge.
Yes, I am. All of this excitement has just exhausted me. I'm going to go and speak to the spirits.
Hey, Smolder, did you see how interested the professor was in that map? You know, he's become obsessed by it. I'm pretty certain he's you-know-who. But since nobody knows what you-know-who looks like, there isn't anything we can do until we catch the professor with the goods. I'm sure he's going to go after that buried treasure.
Do you think he's going to find the ghost too?
Give up on that ghost already. The professor's not interested in the ghost. He's here for the treasure of King Rootin'Tootin'.
Do you think he'll give me his ghost detector?
I give up. Come on, let's keep an eye on him.
I want that ghost.
I want that map.
I want that ghost and that map.
Why do you want the ghost? If we can find the map, we can find the buried treasure. If we find the buried treasure, we can pay off our bills, expunge our mortgage, do some fire restoration, and still have plenty of money to live on comfortably. We don't need the ghost.
Our little ghost is worth a gold mine, Jim. Think about it. First, the book rights. Then, the TV and movie deals. Next, we're on the cover of the National Enquirer. Misquoted, of course. We'll sue for millions like the celebrities do. Oh, this ghost is worth a fortune to us.
But you're forgetting that Miss Bibbidi-Bobbidi-Boo wants to relocate the ghost down the road. And I say let her. This stuff scares me, this ghosty stuff. I don't like it. And there's plenty of money in that buried treasure if we can just find it.
And what if we don't find it? What if someone found that treasure a long time ago? Somebody who was smart enough to sell it on the black market so no one would know. That would leave us with nothing but a good story to tell. Oh no, that ghost is going to stay right here.
Not if Miss Bibbidi-Bobbidi-Boo has her way. And I hope she does. I don't like the idea of living with a ghost. Living with you is scary enough.
I want that map, and I want to talk to Olivia myself, and Madame Von Fruitcake is going to hide that for me. Hey, you! Hey, wake up!
What are you doing? Do you know how dangerous it is with
the monster? Yeah. Look, I want to talk to Olivia myself. Get her back here.
Well, that's what I've been trying to do. It's not as easy as you might think.
Oh, how hard can it be? I'll handle this myself.
You don't have the gift.
Oh, really? Watch this. Jim?
Oh, yes, dear.
Get lost.
Yes, dear.
Don't tell me I don't have the gift.
That's not how it works. You can't just order a ghost to come back.
Yeah.
It takes concentration.
Yeah. Now watch. Olivia, get your butt in here. I want to talk to you now.
Oh, my goodness. She's coming. She's coming up here. She's sitting in the stool.
Am I good or what?
I'm amazed.
Okay, Olivia. Frankly, my dear, I don't understand why you want to leave here. Why, you've been here so long, it must seem like your own place. Oh, and it's so beautiful here. No ugly shopping malls. And all those pretty trees and things.
Olivia said it was fine until you and your husband moved in. And all the construction started and all the fighting. She never had a moment's peace.
No problem. Jim and I will get couples counseling.
Olivia said no, she still wants to leave.
Well, we could make you part of the staff. Why, we could get you health benefits.
Mrs. Lodge, she's dead. Why would she need health benefits?
Death benefits.
No.
Same. How about a special ghost appearance on Oprah? Or would you prefer Dr. Phil?
No.
I've got it. Breast implants.
Don't be ridiculous. What? You want breast implants? But who would see them? What, you want me to ask her? Olivia wants me to ask you, how's your cooking?
I don't know what she's talking about. I'm a good cook.
Well, she said your cooking didn't do much for your husband that last night when you made him sauerbraten. That's not on the menu tonight, is it?
Emeril Agassi, she's not.
I don't know what she's talking about. My husband died of natural causes. And if you don't keep that to yourself, Madame Zelda, you just might eat something tonight that will make it even easier for you to talk to the dead.
Yes?
Madame Zelda, did I overhear what I think I overheard?
What do you think you heard?
Well, I think I overheard that my dear sweet wife poisoned her previous husband.
Olivia did seem to suggest that.
Yeah. Could you ask her one more question? Could you ask her if I should avoid my dear wife's meal tonight and go to McDonald's instead? And while you're at it, ask her what the Happy Meal toy is this week.
Firebug? Why are you calling him a firebug?
Firebug?
Olivia says that she put out the fires in the kitchen and in the linen closet herself.
Olivia put out the fires.
She said you were planning to get your wife out before it was too late, weren't you?
I don't know what she's talking about. I had nothing to do with the fire in the kitchen, in the linen closet, or the one in the basement that didn't quite catch.
Olivia never mentioned the fire in the basement.
Well, I need to talk to my wife right now. Phyllis! Phyllis, come here! Phyllis, I want to talk to you right now. Phyllis? Oh. Phyllis, did you kill your previous husband?
What are you talking about?
I overheard everything. That ghost has no reason to lie. Did you poison your husband for the insurance money?
Jim, do I look like the type of person who'd be capable of doing something like that?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't.
Well, I don't think I believe you. How do I know I'm not the next one on your culinary hit list?
And how do I know I'm not on your hit list?
What are you talking about?
I overheard your little conversation with Olivia. You've been setting the fires here. Why? To collect the insurance money?
Oh, no, I didn't set any fires.
You're trying to burn me up!
No. That's just a lie. That's a lie. It's all a coincidence.
But you're still trying to burn me up.
No, you're trying to poison me.
I'll kill you!
Ow! Your mother was right.
Hey, you! Knock it off. Hey, I didn't join the FBI. Whoops, I mean the Boo Organization to break up domestic squabbles. Now you two just knock it off.
Huh. There's a couple you'll see on Jerry Springer someday.
No thanks to you.
I was just getting ready to back you up.
Yeah, you mean back yourself up into the next room.
Speaking of chicken, it's time for me to go fix Madame Zelda's next meal. And if you don't keep your mouth shut, it could be your last.
And I'm going to go do some more repairs in the linen closet. Madame Zelda, that ghost of yours has a big mouth. And you know far too much. I'd keep my mouth shut if I were you, because if you don't, the next fire in this building might be in your room tonight. Get it?
Got it.
Good.
Oh, what am I going to do? Professor.
Excuse me, Madame Zelda.
that.
Could I possibly see that map?
No, I'll hold on to this for the time being, if you don't mind.
But if you and I work together, think how much faster we'll find the treasure of King Rootin'Tootin'.
You know, Professor, I think just finding the map was enough, and Olivia should be able to leave this place right now.
But shouldn't we be sure? For poor Olivia's sake.
He's such a nice guy. So thoughtful.
My plan is to give the map to the Museum of Ancient Things. Let them find their own treasure, and then Olivia will be able to leave. And if not right away, well, she's been here 100 years. A little longer won't matter. And the treasure will return to the rightful owner.
But we could be the rightful owners. Finders, keepers.
Oh, Professor, do I denote a hint of greed?
Ghost hunting would be so expensive. I'm just trying to help fund our research.
No, I couldn't do anything like that, and then I'm surprised you would even suggest it.
Madam Zelda, perhaps you should consider...
No, I won't hear another word about it. I'm going to talk to Olivia. Olivia, you know what I wanted to know. What is it like when... What's that? You want to tell me something about the professor?
She's lying.
She didn't say anything.
Oh, right.
She says you are not who you say you are.
She is lying!
Olivia wants to know what you did with the real Professor Spector.
I don't know what she's talking about.
She said you are not the real Professor Spector. She said you are... Oh, my God! She said you are Spencer Reese International Cat Burglar!
Zelda! You've learned far too much for your own good.
No, I don't know anything, and what I do know won't be our little secret. I promise.
I suggest you give me that map. I'll find the treasure, get out of the country quick, and no one has to get hurt. Now give me that map!
Hey, what's going on here? Hey, what are you doing?
Toothache. Madam Zelda has a toothache. I'm just trying to help.
Oh, Professor, you seem to be a man of many talents. Dentistry too?
Yes, well, I suggest you take a couple of aspirin and call someone in the morning.
Oh.
And I've got to be going ghost hunt, don't you know? Madam Zelda?
Uh-huh.
Until you get that tooth checked, I'd keep my mouth shut if I were you.
Nobody likes me anymore.
Madam Zelda, we need to discuss further the possibility of relocating our ghostly friend to Washington headquarters. I mean to Booze Washington headquarters.
I don't think she wants to go to Washington, Mr. Spalder.
Well then, if she won't go willingly, is there any way that we can take her there?
Oh, that would be wrong. I would never take part in anything like that, even if it were possible.
Madam Zelda, I'm warning you. My reputation is at stake here. They're trying to get rid of me down at the bureau over this end.
Spalder! He's always referring to Boo headquarters down in Washington as the Bureau. Come on, we have to go and watch the professor.
No, but.
No more buts.
Madam
we
Zelda,
have to go
I am
now.
Warning you. I
Come
will
on.
Get that ghost to Washington, D.C., and if you try to stop me, so help me, let's just get going.
No.
Oh, what am I gonna do? Everybody's trying to get rid of me. Mr. Lodge is a pyromaniac who burned down their house, who started all the fires around here, and even burned down their house in the Hampton. And Mrs. Lodge, Olivia has told me that she poisoned her first husband. And Professor Lionel Spector is who he said he is. He's really Spencer Reese International Cat Burglar. And all he wants to do is get the treasure from King Rootin'Tootin'. Everybody wants to get rid of me. Oh, what am I going to do? My life is in danger. What's that, Olivia? You say you'll help me because I helped you by finding the map? Oh, thank you, Olivia. Thank you. What's that? You say Fox Mulder and Dana Scullery are really FBI agents, and if I tell them what I know, they'll save me? Oh, thank you, Olivia. Thank you, darling. Goodbye. Oh, Mr. Smolden, Miss Scullery, come quick.
Where's that music coming from?
It's me.
Come over here quick, I have something important to tell you.
What is it, Madam Zelda? You changed your mind? You're going to help me capture that ghost and save my reputation?
Alder.
Enough with the ghost already. Olivia has told me that...
Oh, no, I'll never give up. No! I'll never give up. I know the truth is out there, and that is right under my nose. And I also want to trust no one, and I'm going to let you or anyone else stop me from getting the proof I need.
Good job.
Well, Olivia told me that you're both FBI agents. Is that true?
Well,
is it true?
Yes, it's true. Now you're interfering in the federal investigation. Hand over that ghost.
Mulder, shut up! Yes, it's true. We are FBI agents, formerly associated with the now-defunct Hex Files. We're here on a case.
Would it have anything to do with Spencer Reese, international cat burglar?
How did you know?
Olivia told me. She also told me that he was here, that you were both FBI agents, and if I told you everything, she would help. You would help me.
So, Olivia is an informant. You see, Scully? As an informant, she could be a great useless gun in Washington. We need to get the ghost to Washington.
Smolder, if I hear one more word out of you about Olivia, I'll see to it that you join her in the afterlife.
There's more. Excuse me, there's more.
No one will stand in my way. I'm tired of being the laughingstock of the Bureau.
Mr. Lodge has been setting fires around here for the insurance money.
Pull yourself together, man. You're losing it. Have you taken your medication?
Even burned down their house in the Hamptons.
I don't need any medication. I need that ghost.
Mrs. Lodge poisoned your first husband.
I'm warning you, Smolder.
No, I'm warning you. And if you stand in my way...
No, don't shoot.
Oh, Smolder, you're getting nuts.
That's okay. It's just an itch. But you better try me that ghost, or I'll come back and satisfy that itch.
Smolder, come back here now! I'm gonna call the director for backup, Smolder!
Oh, this ghost hunting and this map has caused me nothing but trouble. I'm going to get out of here as quickly as I can. My life is in danger. People want to get rid of me. Oh my gosh.
Uh-oh. I think I'll catch up on my reading.
And I think I'll put another log on the fire.
And I think I'll try out a new recipe.
I'm getting out of here. This is a bad scene.
There's more.
It's terrible. Oh, madam.
This just hasn't been my day.
Did you hear that screaming? Where's that screaming? Where's the screaming coming from?
What was that scream? I was in my room reading. I heard a scream.
I don't know. I heard a scream.
I don't know.
I heard it. Yeah, it was terrible.
I was just reading and it was so loud.
Where's the ghost? Where's the ghost?
Zelda has been murdered.
Why not?
Mother Zelda is dead. Someone stabbed her with a dagger.
Whoa.
Now it's time for you to become a detective. What do you think? Who committed this murder?
You did.
Here's how the voting works. First, I'll ask each character to speak. Then, after we've heard from all of them, I'll ask you to vote by applauding for the one you think murdered Madame Zelda. Professor, you darling creature, did you murder Madame Zelda?
I'm an honest thief. I don't kill people, I just rob. And I had the map, I had no reason to kill her.
That's
I'm
enough.
Innocent.
That's enough from you. Who is the murderer? We'd like to know. I would like Phyllis Lodge to tell me.
I'm innocent. I'm innocent. I would never stab anybody with a dagger. I only use poison.
Very interesting. Jim Lodge, would you tell us, please? Are you the murderer?
No, I'm not that type. I would never do anything like that. I might set a little fire to keep things warm and cuddly. I might never stab it.
That's enough from you.
Yeah,
okay. Fox Smolder. What a name. Did you kill Madame Zelda?
No. See, I use guns. I use a gun.
Janet, could it be possible in this world that you would be the murderer of Madame Zelda?
She's guilty.
Yeah.
I'm really not sure. I'm kind of in and out of it.
You're not sure. Very good. Now, it's time for you to vote. For the murderer.
She's guilty.
Shut up. I will put my hand over the person, and you will tell me by your applause who is the murderer. Is it the professor? Come here, you fool. Is it him?
No. Whoa! Oh,
yeah. That's very interesting.
Smart.
All right, this gentleman.
He's very stupid.
Thank you so much.
This lovely lady.
She did it.
Fascinating.
Thank you.
Could it be the lovely Janet? We have come to the conclusion.
Yeah?
The murderer is, by your applause, Janet!
All right. Now, we're going to take her away.
Going to take her away?
Oh! Where? Look!
What?
In the back there!
Oh, my goodness!
Mario!
It's a ghost! It is technically the ghost.
There she comes! Oh. It's Olivia!
Olivia! You never look better. Olivia! You've kept your figure. Madame Zelda. Ladies and gentlemen, do you have chills? I have the chills. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our show. Let's hear it for the actors in this show. And now, we introduce Sam Jones playing Phyllis Lodge. Sam Jones! Yay! Tod Spense to play Jim Lodge. Yay! The murderer is Donna OKeefe to play Janet, the DJ. And Sandy Geffner will play, or has played, Professor Lionel Speckner. Jack Martinez, step forward, please. Take a bow. He's playing Schwartz. And the lovely and the short Betty Coven playing Scullery. Olivia the Ghost, the lovely creature, played by Toby Richman. Our director for this night's evening is Alice Lemon Marylou's in the back. Our pianist was Carol Robinson. Our sound technician is Larry Reed. Our stage manager, is Barbara Eannarino. Fabulous. I'll say it again, Eannarino. Our sound manager. Oh, forget her. And Madam Zelda happens to be the lovely Mary O'Connor Galliani.